See, our next interview question is that how we can do Ajax-based testing. See, Ajax-based testing, we have to do lot of explicit weights. See, let me show you example. See, this is the Ajax-based testing. I write down here HELL. So see, the things are coming here. So these are coming under Ajax. So it might take some time to come out. You can search on Yahoo also, you can search on Google also. See, if multiple times you say you select a thing from drop down, other drop downs are also dependent on it. Okay, in that old case also we have to put lot of explicit weights. So see, there could be lot of example, but this is a tip which you can use in interviews. You can give this example that it take times and we have to put lot of explicit weights at the time of testing Ajax based applications. Okay. Next commonly asked interview question is how to handle multiple windows in a web driver. See, I have discussed one of my example in one of my video related to Naukri.com. Okay, in that there was multiple windows were coming, so we used windows handles. Okay, with the help of windows handles, we can switch between the windows and perform operations. So answer is we can use with the help of windows handles, and I am having my example also. Next important interview question is what is difference between find element and find elements. So find element will find the first element on the page at a given criteria. It could be through XPath, ID. So as the first element it will find on the page starting from top left to bottom right, it will use it. Okay, this is find element. And find elements will extract all the matching elements and they will put in a list. See, if I want to find all the elements having tag name as A, means all the links, and so we will use find elements and we will put in them in a list. Okay, if you want all radio buttons in the page, you can get all the find elements of radio button and can put in a list. Okay. Next interview question is how to handle alerts in WebDriver. See, I have already given this example that we have a class with the name as alert. We can switch to that alert and accept will click on OK. Dismiss will click on cancel. Okay, so this is the way we can handle. We can have created the object of alert class, and this is the way we can handle an alert. Next interview question is how to take screenshots in Selenium. See, to take a screenshot, there is a predefined class known as take screenshots in Java. Okay, see, we have a predefined class in Java that is in for Selenium, that is take screenshots. Okay, with the help of take screenshot class we can take the screenshot. Got the things? Next interview question, how to handle bitmaps in Selenium. See, we do not have any concept of bitmap in Selenium. We cannot compare any two images in Selenium. There are certain Java APIs you can use them, but in automation I don't prefer to use it. Okay, next question is what is object repository. See, object repository different terms. We have a property files in QTP, we have object repository, so it could be confusing. See, the property file where we put all the our elements is our object repository for Selenium. Okay, next commonly asked interview question, how you can upload and download a file in Selenium. See, in Chrome we can directly download it, it simply download it, but in Firefox we need to change some parameters, and to upload a file it can simply work with send keys. Okay, if it is not working with send keys, then there we can use auto IT tools also. Okay, we can to use auto IT tool also. See, the next interview question which is asked, how to automate calendar. See, this is asked practically many times. I have given my video, it is having all the informations related to it. This is the program which I have created. If you want, you can have it. It's very lengthy to explain it out. You can watch my videos. There I have given how we can use it. There are multiple date functions which we need to use. Okay, and we need to take CX paths of right arrow, left arrow, all these combination will be there. Okay, so we will be using multiple date functions in it. Okay, just watch my video, and if you have any issue you can come to me. Another commonly asked question is how we can check whether our checkbox is in check position, means our checkbox is correctly tick or not. For this, what I can do, this simple line, just driver dot find element by dot xpath, find the xpath of your checkbox. Okay. And there is an attribute known as get attribute. Dot get attribute. Here you can put the attribute named as check. This attribute will return true or false. If it is checked, then it will return true. If it is unchecked, then it will return false. Okay. Next general interview question is, can we automate captcha? No, we cannot automate captcha. Okay. Then what is its use? Fine. So another common question is, how we can run Eclipse script from command prompt with the help of ent. See, for this we need a build.xml. Okay, already I have covered in my framework. We need a build.xml. Fine, we need all the jars at a common location. And that your build.xml should have the targets of compiling and building. And after having all the jars at centralized single location, we can use ent to run our script. Okay, got the answer. Next question, how we can execute the same script on different browser. See, I have shown this code multiple times to you. Fine, so we will have web driver is equal to null. Keep it as driver one because we are already having a driver upstairs and we are considering browser as Mozilla. Now we can put if conditions, if br dot equals Mozilla, then we can put driver is equal to new Firefox driver. Okay, else fine, go here, if browser equals to Chrome, fine, then we can make our driver as Chrome driver. Okay, if it is IE, then you can make it. So this is the way, say it's Chrome, then we can make it as new Chrome driver. Okay, now if it is I can initialize it as I. If it is Edge, then I can initialize it as Edge. So this is the way I can execute my script on different browser. Getting the things? So next interview question is, what is displayed function? Okay, it verifies whether the element is visible to human or not. It is visible. It assumes that it is available, but it checks for the visibility of the element. What I do, I write it here, driver.findElement by checkbox dot is displayed. See, it will check whether that element is visible to human eyes or not. So our next interview question is commonly asked, what is difference between is element present and is displayed? See, is element present is not available in WebDriver. It was available in Selenium RC. Okay. See, it has been asked that can we test flash images in Selenium? Yes, we can test, but we should have the code of that flash image. Okay, we should have the code of that flash image. Next interview question is, how can we verify an object that is present on multiple pages? So I create a new function that is public boolean is element present and I pass the X path. So I write out the code here. WebDriver driver is equal to new Firefox driver. Okay. And I pass the element here. And here we can pass this XPath. I pass this XPath here. Okay, and we get the size of the list dot size. Okay, if the size is greater than me one means we have a XPath available in f equal to size of the list. If s is greater than 0, okay. Then our function will return true that element is present, okay. Else it will return false that element is not present. So with the help of this function we can check the object is present or not. Okay, so as soon as we need to verify any object we can call this function, pass the value. I have to correct it, it's not, I have to pass that value and it will be checked in this function whether the element is present or not. You have to make it elements. It was my mistake, it was size. Okay, now it is fine. Here is the next interview question, that how can we select the third value from drop down. It is very simple. We will be creating the object of select class. Say I have created the object of select class with ID and I have to select it by index. Fine, you can select by name also, but if it is particular three you have to select it by index. So the next interview question which is asked is, Selenium support HTTPS protocol or not? So the answer is yes, it supports HTTPS protocols. Okay, so how to take get columns from table. Sorry for that background noise, actually my class for US is also going on, so that comes sometime in recording. Okay, I am checking while recording whether it is working fine or not, so please ignore it. Now to handle the columns, let me go to rediffmoney.com. Under rediffmoney.com, do one thing. Go to more gainers. See, now we have a table here. Okay, so this is a table. Now let's see how we can get rows and columns. So if you go and inspect any element,
what you can see, there are multiple TR. TR means tables rows, and if you go inside it, there are TD. TD means table columns. Got the point? TR means table rows and TD means table columns, or TD you can also call as table cells. Okay, if I want to get total rows and total columns, what I can do, just go here, inspect, copy, XPath. Okay, next, inspect element, copy, XPath. See, what you can see here, TR is increasing, that is rows are increasing, 1, 3, there could be a gap. Okay, now if you want to take column, inspect it, copy, XPath, inspect it, copy, oh just a second, copy, XPath, and paste it. So here you can see the columns are, here rows are increasing and here cells are increasing. So this is how we can get the column numbers and rows numbers. See, this is the one of the common question asked, how many scripts you are writing and executing. So it basically, this answer basically depends on your project. So most of the time you can answer it out, there are around 7,000, 5,000 test cases in my project, and I have written around 1,000 test cases and executing them. Okay, another question. Difficulties. Phased in your project. Okay. What are all the difficulties your project faced in your project? So see, difficulties, just write it down if possible. One of the difficulty we face is the object identification. Okay, because in Edge or IE browser I face this issue many times. Second difficulty is Ajax components, related to Ajax components. It gives some difficulty to find these Ajax components, and sometimes these Ajax components are browser based, so we need to write separate code for separate browsers. Second difficulty is variable XPath. Okay, XPath is varying, is changing constantly, that can be an issue. Another could be changing the requirements in UI. Okay, this is the fourth problem we have to feel, that requirement is changing constantly of UI. Okay, so XPath will change, multiple changes will come constantly. Okay, and another issue which I face is adding a new test under current project. See, we are working in a project, every test case was freezed, so automation was also done, and suddenly a new test case comes up. Okay, so in that case we have to change the property files, testng.xml files everywhere. See, the next most important question is, which driver implements will allow headless mode? What is headless mode? Headless mode is basically we don't launch our browser and things start working. So it is HTML unit driver. Okay, with the help of, remember this is the answer, with the help of HTML unit driver we can do anything without launching the browser. Okay, next question is, how we can drag and drop from one place to another place. See, with the help of actions class we can drag and drop. I have already explained this in my previous videos, that I am dragging from one place and dropping somewhere else. Another interview question, the famous question, is how many type of frameworks are there and which one to use, how can we decide it. Okay, see, primarily there are two type of frameworks, one is data driven and another one is hybrid. Okay,
There are two type of frameworks which are primary. Okay, another key, you can say there is a keyword framework. So hybrid is basically keyword plus data driven. It is a mixture of keyword and data driven framework. And we also have a concept of POM, page object model, which is with page factory. Okay, so we have the concept of POM and page factory, and we also have Cucumber BDD. Okay, so we have different type of frameworks available. See, if you think your project is not stable and it's going to change by time, then I will advise go with data driven page object model. This is very useful. We have where we have similar pages. For example, see, if you go with any e-commerce website, if you go with Flipkart, if you go with Amazon, so they have same things. Okay, just everything is same, just the product's layout is different there. So in that type of websites, page object model is very, very useful. Okay, so what I can say, if your project is unstable, then better go with data driven. And if you think your project is unstable, okay, and you are having lot of similar type of pages, then you should go with page object model, POM. And if you think your project is very much stable, okay, then I would say go with hybrid, because changing things in a hybrid framework are little bit giving issues. Okay, so go with hybrid if it is stable product. See, Cucumber is totally a different concept. You have to write, it is a feature file, and that we have to link the things. Okay, so now it depends on your requirement which type of framework you want to use. Okay, go with your requirements. So we will be working on next interview question, that is, what is a page object model? Actually, I have covered it fully, but what I can say, we create one class for each page. In that class, we have the elements. Let me discuss this question at the end, okay? Because this is the most important, and you will be aware for it. Where I am cutting from here, okay? I will discuss it at the end. Next important question is how to connect the Selenium with database. See, I have shown it in my database videos. We need to use JDBC connectivity to do connection with database. Okay, in one of my videos, it is, I think 23 is there, and 29 is also there. 23 is related to database. Okay, so we use JDBC connectivity. Fine. Next question is, fine, for this we will be using JDBC connectivity, and to know more about it, there are the separate videos I have already created, okay, in my channel. Next is, which tool do you use for reporting purpose? See, we can generate XSLT reports with the help of TestNG. Next important interview question is, why you choose Selenium for automation? See, Selenium is an open source tool. It's a platform independent tool. It works on multiple browsers. It can be integrated with continuous integration tools like Jenkins. And current version which we are using for Selenium is quite stable. Okay, and there is lot of support available for this tool on internet. Okay, with the help of Selenium Grid, what we can do, we can run our scripts parallelly. Fine. Next important question is, what is difference between JavaScript and a Java program? See, JavaScript is basically a language which is understood by the browsers, and Java is the normal Java program which we write on our C, this Eclipse we are writing upon. And in Java, it is first converted into class file. Okay, it is compiled in and converted into class file, then it is being used. See, when you go to page source of any program, you will see JavaScript. Fine, that is not the Java. Okay, next is send email. So we have a function known as send email.